In this video, I'm going to talk to you about a very specific case that AI was able to solve. We have a client, they are in the legal industry. When they are meeting customers, they need to capture lots of details. Those discovery meetings can take hours. And the problem is that whenever these details are being captured, the lawyers and their assistants need to go back all the time to recording and grab information. And in some cases, they are missing important data. They came to us to our AI part of Amazing Business Results, because we have one part of our company is dealing with CRM systems, and another part of the company is dealing with AI implementations. They came to us to find an AI solution that will be able to help them solve this problem. They came with a big budget. The thing is, the solution is free. Obviously, it's very difficult for me as a consultant and a business owner to let go a great offering as we will pay as much as you want, just solve us the problem by giving a free solution, but it's exactly what we did. In this session, I'm going to show you exactly the solution that we utilize. It's free of charge. Anybody can use it. It's fantastic for companies like ours when we are meeting customers. We are getting information using audio, if it's in person, sometimes using Zoom recordings or some other meeting device. And all that can be plugged into an AI tool that you can then listen to it. It can create a podcast that you can listen to the podcast in a nice and easy way. And you also can have a prompt that you can ask questions related to the information that was uploaded. So let's begin. If you will see my screen, this is Notebook LLM. It's a Google product. Very, very nice product. And I will take you step by step on how to use it. On the left side, you will have sources, which we are going to talk about it in a second. The sources will be anything that you want to have data. So those are your data points. Can be YouTube videos, can be recordings, can be audio files, PDFs, architectures, anything can be uploaded to this section. In the middle, you will have a chat that you can, using prompts, you can ask questions regarding the sources that you uploaded. And on the right side, I will leave it as a surprise. Super cool. So first of all, obviously I cannot show you real data of customer meetings, but let's assume that I'm going to take. So we have about 6 videos of why CRM system fail. We are going to grab them and put them as sources so I can show you how it works. So let's go here. We'll grab this one. And I will click on add sources. And the system can upload Google Drive. It can upload links from the website or YouTube. And you can also paste data. In my case, it will be a YouTube link. I will have the first one. And let's grab also the second one. Okay, and I will just pause the video until we are finishing all the 6. I don't want to waste your time. So right now I have those 6 sources. Those can be YouTube, but it can also be a meeting recording that you upload. It can be an audio file that you upload. So it can be basically anything that you want to scan. I will also grab some notes. So let's say that one of the pieces of information that I received is that 90% of CRM implementations fail. So that's an important piece. And let's assume that I also know that the human factor is the biggest problem and not really the application. So humans will be the top reason for the failures. Okay, and let's make it English. Beautiful. Okay, so that will be my notes, and I will click in here, convert to source. Now, in a real environment, when I'm in a meeting, which last week I was in Florida. I was meeting few clients across different areas. Super difficult meetings. So those are 8 a.m. to 5, 6 p.m. every day with different clients. I need to capture notes. So during the meeting, I will have my laptop open. I will click on record, obviously with the client consent. I will click on record, and that will record the meeting. Those recording will be uploaded to this section. In addition, I'm capturing notes, things that I think that are important and we need to capture them. So I will have the notes, and whenever I'm finishing every section of the meeting, I will click on convert to notes, and then it's here. In addition, sometimes the client will say something that is important. So I will go to Google. So let's say I know that the client say the CIO magazine, he said that about 80-90% of the implementations will fail. So I will go here, I will check. Okay, I don't see it here. And let's go to the next one. So the client was talking about that, and I do see it here. I will grab it as a data point. I will go here. I will click on add website, and I will paste it here. Okay, so I can have, I think, around 100 data points in this section. This is step number one, grabbing the information. Step number two will be whenever the team members or me, for example, I want to go over the data, I can go here and ask questions. For example, what are the main reasons that CRMs will fail? Okay, and then the system will ask those sources and will produce the answer. Okay, and you can see here that all the reasons and user frustration, data errors, and by the way, all that is correct because I created all those videos, so I do know it's true. Okay, now let's dig into one of them. Okay, so as an example, let's talk about training, which is one of those issues. How can I fix the training problem? And then the system will also report about that. And everything is from the sources that you loaded. Okay? Now, let's take it to my environment. I will be with the client having a full architecture session of a full day. And whenever I finish the architecture, then I need to send it to my team. My team and I will meet, and I need to translate everything in my brain without losing the important points, obviously, to multiple people. So we have the account manager, the developers, the lead developer. Many people are asking questions. Instead of that, I'm just sharing this notebook with them, and they are asking the bot all the questions that will ask me. And it's sad to say, the bot is doing a better job than what I would do. Because the bot can maintain all the information and data points in one shot. Those videos will be hours of data. And it's able to analyze it in seconds. And now let's go to the next part. So if I will go to Studio, I can click on Generate. That will be the most basic thing. You can also customize what I'm going to show you. I will click on Generate. It takes about 1 or 2 minutes until it's being generated. The result will be a podcast that is being generated based on all this data. I would use this section of the podcast only whenever I want to learn the overall of the project. So let's talk about my team. Before they are going into the prompt, they will click here on generate. They will have a podcast of about 20 minutes long that will summarize the entire 10 hours in in a podcast type of a conversation, which is super nice and engaging to hear. So that will be in a second. I will play so you can listen to it. And then I will show you one more layer of interaction that you can do with this podcast that I think will blow up your brain. So let's give it a second. I will resume whenever it's done. Okay, so right now I can see that the conversation was created, and let's check it out.
Welcome to Pulse on Productivity. You shared some really compelling reasons why customer relationship management, or CRM, often doesn't quite live up to its promise, especially in growing companies.
Mm-hmm.
Today, we're diving deep into those sticking points, really trying to pull out what you need to know to make CRM actually work.
That's right. And your observations, they really echo some pretty stark statistics out there.
Yeah.
We're seeing reports like that one from Harvard Business Review you mentioned, suggesting a large chunk of CRM projects. I mean, sometimes they say as high as 90% just fail to drive growth.
90%.
Yeah, it's high. And the recurring theme across the material, the thing that keeps popping up, is the human factor. That seems to be the core reason.
The human factor. Okay.
And that's what we'll be focusing on unpacking today.
Exactly.
Okay, so you can see that right now I'm getting the data with a podcast, which is probably one of the nicest ways to consume data. Let me just push a little bit forward and then I will show you something else.
If you lack that context about their specific interests and needs, you need that unified view across all touch points for effective sales and marketing.
And reporting suffers too, right?
And I will also download this file and I will add it to the description below in case that you want to listen to the entire thing that was created. Also on the left side, you can see that you have all those sources and it will go one by one. It will grab information. What I also like about it, you will see that across all those assets, you will have some data that is being shared, and in this 26 minutes versus 6 hours of data, it will discuss only the things that are unique. So it will not repeat the same information again and again. Now, let's assume that you want to ask questions. So those people that are creating the podcast, you want to ask them questions and get involved. So let's see how that works. You will click on interactive mode. Right now it's beta version. Very soon it will be live. I will click on play and they will start to talk.
Welcome to Pulse on Productivity. You shared some really compelling reasons why customer relationship
management. Okay, and now once I will play again, I will click on join and I will ask questions.
Man, or CRM often doesn't.
Hey there, want to share your thoughts on this?
Beautiful. So I guess I'm part of your podcast now. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Welcome to the conversation. We're thrilled to have you join us.
Yeah, your thoughts and questions are a big part of what makes this podcast work. Oh yeah, let's hear it.
Okay, so first of all, it's super, super cool. Now, tell me something. I like to know what will be, like in really 1 minute, what will be the most important things that I need to do whenever I'm creating a new CRM system?
Oh, that's a fantastic question. Let's unpack this real quick.
Absolutely. If you've only got a minute, here are the absolute essentials.
First, and this is huge, have crystal clear objectives.
Exactly. Know why you're getting a CRM and what you want it to do for your business. Oh, go for it.
Can you give me an example of an objective? I have no clue what to do next.
Absolutely. Okay, let's unpack this.
A clear objective is basically what you want to achieve with your CRM.
Think of it like this. Instead of just saying get a CRM, be specific.
For example, an objective could be increase sales lead follow-up by 20% in the next quarter.
Or maybe reduce customer support response time by 15%.
Beautiful. So you can see that this is on the sick level. Now, I can also tell you that I'm experimenting some tools right now that are even more than that. I will share them later on in the channel whenever they are more mature, but the world is going to a crazy place. Those are the things that you can do out of the box with a Notebook LM. Now, you have your more goodies. You can generate an FAQ, you can create a study guide. You can check the timeline, which is going to generate it right now. Really, really, really interesting. Okay, so you can check it out here. Now, bottom line, In order to use it in real environment, if you need to capture information, you can or use it to summarize something that you want. For example, grab multiple sources and just listen to it. Another option is, like what I'm using it for, is when I'm architecting a system, meeting clients. I have lots of data sources, meeting audio files, videos, notes, diagrams, and so on. I will load them into the sources, and then I will generate the podcast. My team can listen to it, and then they can ask specific questions regarding it. Lately, we had a CRM implementation, very big one for a very large scale company. Lots and lots of details, many, many hours of conversations. Those were uploaded here. The team leads and the different people, and even whenever we are working on the CRM, the developers are also inquiring the same system. So it saves us lots of time, and the results are much, much better than what we would do as humans. I hope that you like the session. This is only one tool. There are hundreds of tools in our inventory. We have AI receptionist, AI chatbots. We have automated tools that whenever something happens in your marketing, a phone call goes out, we can create reports and dashboards. It's just endless what we can do with AI these days. So if you need any type of help, contact us. In the description below, there is a link and you can contact us. And obviously, if you have any questions, shoot them in the comments below. Thumbs up, always appreciate it. Thank you very much. We'll see you in the next session.